वक्रतुंड महाकाय कोटि सूर्य समप्रभा निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देवा सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा।
Schools promote excellence amongst their students, where students are nurtured with the largest Indian international education systems blending with Indian value systems. GIIS schools are run by Singapore-based non-profit organization, which is the Global Indian Foundation. Show of soaring competence, glow of vibrant bionites. It is larger than dreams. It is the craziness that is rife. It is the creation of life. It is the festival of life. A very special good evening, ladies and gentlemen, the galaxy of intellectuals, esteemed guests, teachers, and our lovely students. You will discover how special this evening is as we unfold the colors of this day.
Hello.
Our chief guest for the day, Hello. Mr. Abdul Qayyum Hello. Khan. A.K. Khansar is the Director General of Police in the Anti-Corruption Bureau of the Telangana Government. He is the former Vice President of the Andhra Cricket Association and the Hyderabad Hockey Association. He is also the former President of the AP Football Association. He has received the President's Police Medal for Distinguished Service in the year 2007. Sir A.K. Khan is the 59th Commissioner of the Hyderabad City. Atithi Devo Bhava. Our culture has placed our guests at par with God. And so are our esteemed guests who have gathered here to witness the programs of the evening. We have a special dignitary as our chief guest for the day, Mr. Abdul Qayyum Khan. A.K. Khan, sir, is the former Vice President of the Andhra Cricket Association and the Hyderabad Hockey Association. He is also the Director General of Police in the Anti-Corruption Bureau of the Telangana Government. He has received the President's Police Medal for Distinguished Service in the year 2007. Sir, we welcome you.
आज के पांचवी वार्षिकोत्सव के मुख्य अतिथि श्री एके खान जी को पुष्पगुच्छ देकर स्वागत किया जा रहा है। आज के मुख्य अतिथि श्री एके खान जी को पुष्पगुच्छ देकर स्वागत किया जा रहा है।
Auspicious occasion can never begin without the blessings of Lord. I request the dignitaries to kindly be seated.
हमारे पाठशाला के प्रधानाचार्य श्री अतरुराज जी से अनुरोध करते हैं कि वे मंच पर आए और वार्षिक ब्यूरो प्रस्तुत करें।
What goes around comes around. Good evening. Honorable Chief Guest, Sri A.K. Khan, Director General of Police, Anti-Corruption Bureau, Government of Telangana, respected Executive Vice Chairman, Mr. M.N. Murthy, distinguished guests, adorable parents, faculty members, and my dear children. It's my proud privilege to present the annual report for the year 2013-14. Mission without a vision is non-achievable. Our vision is to endow student with a holistic education that molds the personality of the child. We pursue authenticity, creativity, and excellence in learning. We enable and celebrate learning that is connected, real, and engaging. We empower children for being significant and highly influential, not only within their lives, but also within the education market. We promote multiple intelligence to allow students develop their individual talents. We have a mission, be the difference and become global citizen. Our school is committed in bringing excellent results through engaging programs that are relevant and carry student ownership. We promote innovation through high levels of staff and student engagement, provoking a culture of above and beyond. We have earmarked 14-15 as year of spoken English, and the year 13-14 was declared as year of discipline. We are satisfied with our progress, but will strive for excellence. We embarked on a journey on 25th of June 2009 with 350 students, and today After completion of 5 years, we stand tall with the strength of 1400 students and 200 staff members. School has completed 5 eventful years, and 2014-15 will witness the first batch of class 12 appearing for board examination. Our best wishes and blessings are with them. We have received accolades for a continuous growth in academics and co-curricular activities by Times of India survey on 29 November 2014. We were ranked third best school in Twin Cities amongst all CBSE and international schools. Even further, BrainFeed magazine has also rated GIS Upal as top 20 international schools in India. This is only possible due to untiring efforts of my worthy teachers and able support of parents. School has been rated green category by CBSE sanitation inspection team, and we secured 91.37% in overall hygiene and sanitation. It's rightly said, success is a good fortune that comes from inspiration, aspiration, desperation, and perspiration. Let me proudly announce the success achieved by my students. The first dimension, of course, is always academics. Our IGCSE board examination result for 13-14 has been the best ever. Three students, Akhila Narayanam, Rishita Gampa, Shashank, got merit certificate and distinction under Cambridge International Examination. In CBSE Grade 10 examination, we had Devesh Gedam, Sri Datta, Vedavarshini securing CGPA 10. It means they have secured A1 grades in all 5 subjects. They have also received Certificate of Excellence from CBSE New Delhi. The second dimension is, of course, co-curricular activities. Students have participated and got meritorious performance in inter-school activities. The record of our performance is as follows. Master Vivek of Grade 10, Shishir of Grade 8, Vishwajit of Grade 7 secured first position in mathematics quiz organized by Ruckelford School. Students went to GIS Queenstown, Singapore to participate in youth convention program and showcased their exceptional talent. School received third prize in Oxford Atlas quiz at Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan, Secunderabad. In essay writing and painting competition conducted by AB Archaeology Department, Madhulika of grade 5 got first prize, Tejasvi of grade 6 got second prize, and Varsini got third prize. In hexathlon quiz conducted by Secunderabad Public School, a student secured second position. Going ahead, in Spell B, we have Akshata of grade 7, Nagasa of grade 8, Shreya of grade 7, who was selected for state level competition conducted by Make a Difference. Vedahi of grade 2 received first prize in state level competition conducted by Mass Spell B. Moving ahead, Art and Craft category, we have Mansa Singh, grade 5, stood first in spot painting competition conducted by AB Hakula Sangam. Sahasra of UKG, M. Bhardwaj of grade 8, Abhinav of UKG have received gold and silver medal respectively in Chhaya National School of Art competition. G. Pranay Reddy of grade 6 was selected for state level painting competition on water conservation. K. Shreya of grade 7 and Spandana of grade 11 were selected as best artist in Kamlin competition organized by Times of India. In Olympiads, we have students participating and getting a lot of accolades for us. In International English Olympiad, Master Guru Raj Karthik Karnam of grade 2 secured 35th rank at international level and 4th rank at state level. In 16th National Science Olympiad, Master Srikar of grade 6 secured 135th rank and Master Vivek of grade 10 got 149th rank at national level. In 7th International Mathematics Olympiad, Ms. Sarayu Reddy secured 207th rank at national level. The third dimension is sports and games. Dear parents, we have coaching going on in football, cricket, swimming, skating, karate, and basketball during and after school hours. These sessions, along with the inter-school and inter-house matches, help our young sportsmen sharpen their skills. The achievements are as follows. In swimming, we have Master B. Avisek, grade 9, getting second position in 34th Sub-Junior Winter Aquatic Championship, first position also in School Games Federation of Andhra Pradesh, and third position for 50-meter freestyle in AP 27th edition of Olympic Sports. School also got second position in triathlon due to the participation of Dhirin, Abhishek and Amok Sasang at DPS Nachara. In cricket, we have Master Aniket Reddy, grade 9, getting selected for nationals in Chennai. Miss A. Shreya Reddy of grade 9 got selected for under 19 Rangari district, under 14 Telangana Super 7 team and Hyderabad Cricket Association under 16 category. Master J. Sai Sisir, K. Vishnu, Gyanar Prakash, Pranay Sai have been selected for under 14 category for RR district. Manish Srivas, Manish, Rishabh are selected for RR district under 17 category. We move on to skating now. Ms. P. Shreya Rao, grade 9, got first position in AP State Roller Skating Championship. She also received two gold medals in RR District Open Skating Championship. Further, she bagged one gold and one silver in National. P. Srimant of grade 5 got two gold medals in RR District and one bronze in State Level Championship. Under Karate, we have students Pranita of grade 6, Arnav Reddy from grade 4, Ritvika of grade 11 getting gold medals in Telangana State Karate Championship under the category Kumite. Saket Gaur of grade 4, Vinith of grade 4, Sari of grade 4 received silver medal in the same category along with Abhijit of grade 7, Komali of grade 6 getting the bronze medal. The final dimension of the child's development is of course the social and the spiritual development. We have been keeping up with our value education classes as well as a commitment to send students for various development programs outside the school. Students were engrossed with helping the destitute and old people by visiting orphanages and old age homes. More important is the ethical and moral atmosphere that we try to inculcate in our children. For as we know, values cannot be taught but caught. Students went for national and international educational tours and have developed a spirit of service, friendliness, discipline and teamwork. They also had the opportunity of coming close to nature, the initiatives taken by school. We started IIT Foundation classes for grade 8 to 10 in 13-14. We commenced integrated CBSE curriculum with IIT and MCET coaching for grade 11 and 12 sciences and CSEPT coaching for 11th and 12th commerce. We have inducted NCC Army Wing in our school for grade 8 to grade 10 students. We proudly announce that Ms. Sahana of grade 10 will lead the Telangana and AP contingent on Republic Day Parade on 26th of Jan 2015 at New Delhi. We also have online and printed report cards for all students from grade 1 to 12 detailing their comprehensive performance. We have started case study of students and regular mentoring by the counselors. We have workshops and seminars for teachers to excel in their teaching. We have displayed various exhibitions by students in different subjects. We are also thankful to parents who have been visiting the school to judge CCI events and providing us the valuable feedback. We also started making students meet and interact with eminent personalities. This year, on 30th December 2014, our student met Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam at New Delhi and had set their minds on fire. He is the inspiring force for this year's annual day theme. We also have now variety in CC activities and active involvement of students in all kinds of celebrations and assemblies. The future plans of our school. CCTV cameras have been installed for safety and security of children. Commencement of International Baccalaureate Program will start from 16-17. We are planning to expand 2 acres of our land for sports and games for our children. We'll start very shortly English and Maths lab, which will enhance students' learning skills. We also declare 2015-16 as year of innovative teaching. Now, most of us face challenges in our school, so few points which I have jotted down are like this. Students sometimes do not come with proper attire. So I'll request all my parents to check their wards so that they report to school with confidence and smartness. I'll also urge parents to spend quality time with their kids, actively monitoring their activities, their self-study techniques, and assigned work from school. I'll also request them to check the almanac daily and know more about the school's rules and regulations. One big botheration for our young children nowadays is Facebook and mobile and different gadgets. So I'll request once again the parents of class 6 to 12 to be little vigilant and have strict supervision when the child is accessing internet and especially the Facebook. Because what I find now in a school is that kids are getting distracted and getting trapped in wrong things. And definitely it's affecting their physical and mental development also. Of course, all parents, you have been simply fantastic in a cooperation and collaboration with the school in all activities, starting from debate to Master Safe to Diya decoration to Teacher's Day, Children's Day, so on and so forth. I owe my gratitude to Executive Vice Chairman and the Founder Principal for the legacy that they have passed on to. My heartfelt thanks to every member of staff who have contributed immensely towards the growth of the school. I'd also like to welcome new faculty members. I shall end with inspiring thoughts of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. I am born with potential. I am born with goodness and trust. I am born with ideas and dreams. I am born with greatness. I am born with confidence. I am born with courage. I'll defeat the problem and succeed. I am born with wings. So, I am not meant for crawling. I have wings, I'll fly. I'll fly and fly. My message to all my dear children is that education gives you wings to fly. Achievement comes out of fire in our subconscious mind that I will win. So each one of you assembled here will have wings of fire. The wings of fire will indeed lead to knowledge, which will make you fly as a doctor, or an engineer, or a scientist, or a teacher, or a political leader, or a bureaucrat, or diplomat, or everything you want to be. So you all can do it. But how? The question is, how we can do it? So dear students, start by doing what is necessary, then do what's possible, and suddenly you'll find doing the impossible. Thank you all. God bless all of us.
Such a great facility here. The principal, members of the faculty, parents, and my dear children. Till I came here, I did not know that such a beautiful world has been created here by Sri Narasimhamurthy. I have known him for quite a long time now, but that acquaintance was in a different incarnation earlier. After some time, after a fairly long hiatus, he met me the other day to invite me for this program. I was still thinking that he was doing something else, not in the field of education. But then, when he said that he has created this and showed me the brochure, that was impressive enough. But today, what I am seeing here far exceeds that expectation, what I had seen at that time. Principal's report has given a lot of insight into what is happening here, how these education institutions has blossomed into a great place where so many young minds are getting nurtured. And I'm really, it's really heartening for me to see the way they have been excelling. I'm very sure that they'll enter the world as very confident citizens and into their further education also. To speak, I did not know what to pick up and speak when I came here, but on the way and here and from the dais, whatever has been spoken about Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, perhaps that could be the starting point. I was one of those in Hyderabad, probably many of us know him fairly well. I was one of those who had the privilege of having interacted with him constantly for nearly 3 decades now. My first interaction with him was when he was a scientist in DRDO way back in 1987, when I had been kept in charge of a program when Sri Rajiv Gandhi came to inaugurate a facility called RCI, Research Center Imarat, in defense facilities in our city. That particular project had been conceived and developed by Dr. Kalam. For several days and every day, we kept meeting as to how to make that program that time. Since then, whenever he's in city or whenever I go outside, I have been meeting him. 15 to 20 times I would have met him so far. Each meeting, exchange of ideas, knowing many things about his mind and the way he thinks has always been very exhilarating and very, very inspiring. I was very happy when some visuals were shown here, and it was also told to me just a few days back, several students from here had gone and met him. He is a great inspiration for the students. I always believe, perhaps as Indians, we did great disservice to this country by not getting him as president for a second term. Imagine in the first 5 years he could do so much. In another 5 years, how many young minds he could have ignited, and what a difference it would have made to their lives and to the nation. I'll just pick up some of the ideas from there, juxtapose them with some of the other great minds, and then leave those thoughts to you for thinking. Some of them are intended for the children, but most of them are intended for the teachers and the parents. If we can handle them properly as parents and teachers, I'm very sure that our children definitely would come up very well in life, not just in materialistic way, in many other ways. I'll pick up Einstein first. I keep reading biographies. Biographies, I always have believed, teach you quite a lot. If somebody is writing a biography on somebody else, or somebody writes about his own life in the form of an autobiography, we consider that life to be great. There is something to be learned, to be known about that particular personality. Then only a biography gets written. Einstein's biography, I had read it, and another version came a few years back. I read that version also. There are a lot of simple instances from his life that find place in these books. When it comes to the field of education, two of them which I can readily recall. One of them was when he went to his class. See, mind you, he was a great mathematician, physicist, and then when he went to, he kept on teaching. Even after getting Nobel Prize, he did not divorce himself from the teaching profession. He was very, very passionate about teaching. He went to his class as usual. That day he administered a test in physics to his students. One of the bright students, he got up and said, "Sir, there is something wrong with this." He said, "What is it?" The student said, "This is the same paper that you had given last time for a test." Perhaps you have forgotten and you are giving the same paper. To which in a very matter-of-fact way, Einstein had said, yes, I know, I am giving you the same paper, but this time I am expecting drastically different answers. This is in the field of physics, where lot of concepts, postulates, principles that have been pronounced, we think that they are etched in stone and they remain like that till eternity. He was insisting the students to think, be original, and then go beyond what they have known and keep on evolving and changing with time. This type of originality is what we have to get into the minds of the students. I can tell you, because I am a bureaucrat, perhaps I'll pick up one example. Three, four decades back, when we got into the services, yes, there were two optionals and general studies, essay, a lot of papers were there. It was difficult enough at that time also to get into IAS and IPS. But I was seeing the papers recently, last year, this year papers. Overwhelmingly, general studies is the dominant topic. You take it from me, unless a student is very, very original, he has that thinking capacity, accumulate a lot of knowledge, analytical abilities over a long period of time, he can just not get in. No study circle, no amount of coaching can get a student into this. Those days are gone when we used to just prepare in two subjects and get through civil services. This is what is happening in every field of activity. Unless somebody is original, somebody has an idea in his mind, he cannot succeed in life. This is what the teachers, the parents have to think about. Stop pushing students only to learn, accumulate information, reproduce, and then become big in life. It is just not possible. In the modern day world, it is not possible. You take anybody who has made big, whether it be Steve Jobs or Bill Gates or any one of them, they are not there in those positions for their academic excellence. They are there because they know how to think originally, how to take that idea forward. Same great man, Einstein, there is another small anecdote from him, the passion for teaching. This is intended for the teachers. For the love of teaching, to what extent this great man had gone. See, when he was in that university, Princeton, by then already a Nobel laureate, a small girl, age about 5 years, daughter of a driver in the university, she went to him with the intent to learn mathematics. Every evening he would spend about 1 hour with her, keep teaching the basic elements of arithmetic. When her father came to know what this child was doing, he was very, very embarrassed. He went to Einstein and said, I never thought she was coming and doing this sort of a thing. I'm sorry for what she has been doing. To which Einstein had said, see, how many students are there who are willing to part all their pocket money? She was getting about 20 or 30 cents a month to learn mathematics at that particular age. This girl used to come and put that 10, 15 cents into my hand and then learn mathematics from me. These days, when most of the teachers, when we are coming here, we were discussing the difference between teachers of our generation and teachers of present day, where a lot of economics have come into the profession of teaching. That passion a teacher has to identify a student and then just teach that student for the love of teaching, for the passion of teaching, teachers would have discharged their duty in a very, very great way. The other one, let us not think that we are turning every child into a great person through our efforts. Every child, this message that has been given by Dr. Kalam, I am born with potential, I am born with confidence, I am born with a lot of capabilities, and I am born not to crawl but to soar and fly high, is a great message. It's a great message. Unfortunately, we don't get into the essence of this when we handle our children. We think that I have handled my child so well that he has become this. We never try to get into his mind and then try to see him as a person with potential. We have the National Police Academy here. Two of us are here, IPS officers, me, and we have a DIG, Mr. Satyanarayana from Uttar Pradesh, sitting in front of me. Every day we enter that National Police Academy, we used to see one rough granite rock that has been kept there. The quotation underneath that was very, very interesting. This quotation is a conversation between Leonardo da Vinci, a great painter, sculptor. He was also an engineer. Many other skills he had of the Renaissance period in Italy. The conversation was between him and his friend. His friend asked Leonardo da Vinci, "How is it that you make such beautiful statues out of such rough rocks?" To which Michelangelo had said, "What am I doing? There is already a beautiful statue hidden in that rock. All that I do is pick up the chisel and chisel here and there and bring that shape out. That is all that I am doing." This, though we, some of us have known this, but we fail to realize this when we handle our children. We don't look at the potentialities, the capabilities that a child has. Try to mold every one of them into a particular aspect. In fact, while coming here, Mrs. Radhika, your mathematics teacher, escorted me from my residence. We were discussing how every one of us are trying to put our children into engineering, medicine, nothing else, as if nothing else exists in this world. Why are we not trying to realize what the child is interested in and put that child into that particular subject? The insecurities of our age, only 4 or 5 professions used to be the prime professions in those days. That is gone now. Hundreds of new fields have opened up. A child has to just excel in whatever area that child has the passion, talent, and interest. That and such an atmosphere, if a teacher and a student can create here, the parents can create here, you would have done a great, great service to the future of the children. Two other ideas that I would like to put before you. While emphasizing on academics, let us not forget about the finer aspects of life and character building. In Telugu, if I have to say, we always equate education with Vidya Buddhulu. We never say Vidya alone. Vidya also has a much bigger meaning. It's not just academics. Academics plus a lot of other things make education. Along with education, character molding also goes with it. That's why those two go as Dvandapadal. They go together. Vidya Buddhulu. Unfortunately, we are emphasizing so much on academics these days, we are forgetting everything else about the character building of the child. I'll give you one small anecdote. If we can get such finer feelings into those children, how much of capital we would have given them to excel in lives. You see, a few years back, there were Olympics that were held. These were not the normal Olympics, the special Olympics, what we call the Para-Olympics, where a lot of physically challenged athletes, the children, they participate in those events, normally conducted immediately after the main Olympics. They were conducted in Seattle a few years back. In that, as it happens in any tournament, the last item was the 100 meter dash, because that's the most exciting, and then speed, everything comes into that. That's the one that normally is chosen as the last item. It was chosen. Whole stadium was packed, lot of dignitaries and audience. It was packed with all people. Seven the athletes who had lined up at the starting point, somebody was afflicted with Down syndrome, somebody was lame, somebody was totally mentally retarded. Everybody had some affliction of that nature. All of them were lined up, and at the shooting of that pistol, get set, go, they start running. After going a few paces, one boy who was afflicted with Down syndrome, he trips and falls. After falling, he starts crying with for two reasons. One is the agony of physical pain. Second is the the pain that he is not able to participate in the competition any longer. The other 5-6 would have progressed ahead. One girl who noticed what was happening behind, she stopped in her tracks, started walking back to this boy, lifted him up, and then started walking forward. Meanwhile, the 5 others who had gone much ahead, they looked back what was happening, they walked back to this point, lifted this person, this boy who had fallen initially, and all of them triumphantly marched to the finishing line. Touching the finishing line at the same time, the judge did not have any other option than to declare all of them as the winners, because all of them touched the finishing line at the same time. When we are talking so much of competition in the world, competition would mean what? It's a rat race that is going on. All of us keep moving, marching forward. Somebody falls down in that melee, we trample over him and then go ahead, without looking back to what is happening at him. At what cost we are achieving success, why are we doing, we never see in those ethical ways at all. Success at any cost, success not by ethical means, success at any cost has been the byword of the present day society. This is what we have been inculcating, this is what we have been teaching to our youngsters. Teachers have been doing it, parents have been doing it, the whole society has been doing it. At the end of that, when bad things happen in society, we keep lamenting that society has gone to dogs, or that child has gone bad. How much of pressure we are putting just to excel, just to succeed in life, we don't look at that. Just think over on that point. The last one another example I'll leave to you for thinking, to the parents and student, the teachers, just think about it and see whether we can do anything in that particular way. See, this is a conversation between a pencil and a pencil maker. Pencil and a pencil maker in a pencil factory. A pencil maker has made a very fine pencil, and now before putting it in the box and sending it into the world, he is conversing with it. He says, look, I have put lot of effort, I have paid lot of attention to make you into one of the finest pencils, and then I am sending you into the world. But before going, before sending you into the world, I want to tell you a few things. Please remember these 5 things he tells him, tells the pencil. Remember these 5 things and try to follow. You will be the best pencil ever in this world. Just change. A pencil maker think that this is institution, head of the institution, principal or the teachers. The pencil is a student. The conversation that goes on between the pencil maker and pencil is, look, you remember when you go into the world, you may have to write on a rough surface, smooth surface. Regardless of what surface you are writing, please continue to write. Do not stop. This is advice number 1 that is given. Second one, it says, the most important part of you, that is a pencil, is inside you, not outside. There could be a wooden covering, there could be a beautiful color, design on that, everything. But the only useful part of the pencil is inside, the lead. So always remember, the best part is inside you, not the externalities that surround you. This is one thing that you should remember. Third one is, to be useful, to write very well, you will have to undergo the process of sharpening frequently. Sharpening will cause a lot of excruciating pain, a lot of pain it causes. But then, unless that sharpening takes place, the pencil will not be no use, and it cannot write properly. The other one is, you require to be handled well. Many youngsters think that they have arrived, they are independent, they don't require any counsel, any advice of the parents or anybody outside. This is also not correct. There is a role for elders in society, there is a role for mentors in the lives of the youngsters. An youngster has to realize that. That's why this pencil maker tells the pencil, you will be useful only when you have a handler. At that particular stage, you cannot do on your own. The last one that he tells is far more important. When you have written something, when you realize what you have written is not apt, appropriate, or something wrong that you have written, please do not hesitate to get erased. Erase and write again. Do not continue the same mistake out of ego, out of profanity, out of arrogance, and then say that, yes, this is the way I am going, this is the way I would go. That's why never feel ashamed, never feel embarrassed, never feel diffident to erase what you have written and then write again. These are the 5 points that are given by the pencil maker to the pencil. I wish every teacher inculcates this thing into a student before he sends him into the world. If we can do this as elders, as parents, as teachers, we would have performed our own role towards the future for youngsters. I wish and hope every one of us do it, and all the students here would be having much, much better lives if we can do that. These are some stray thoughts that I thought I would put before you today for your thinking and for the betterment of the youngsters here. I'm really happy that I could come and become part of this. Though I said I'll be here exactly for 1 hour, I don't mind sitting for another half an hour because next program is cancelled. And I'm really impressed with the beautiful facility that Sri Murthy has created here. I'm sure that this will grow much, much bigger, not merely as a physical facility. Ultimately, the identity for this institution is going to be how well placed in different walks of life the students who walk out of the portals of this institution. I wish that happens. I wish all the youngsters here a great future. Thank you.
से हमारी पाठशाला कार्यरत है। प्रति वर्ष कई प्रकार की प्रतियोगिताओं में प्रतिभागी होते हैं। हर समय जीत पाना संभव नहीं होता, परंतु हार सफलता की पहली सीढ़ी होती है। इसी जज्बे के साथ वर्ष 2013-14 में भी हमारे छात्रों ने अपनी प्रतिभा का प्रदर्शन किया। उनको अब पुरस्कार देकर सम्मानित किया जाएगा। जोरदार तालियां होनी चाहिए इन जांबाज खिलाड़ियों के लिए।
Respected Shri A.K. Khan Garu, IPS, Director General of Police, Anti-Corruption Bureau, dear parents, students, and all other guests. ARCA family heartily welcomes all of you to the 5th annual day celebrations of G.S. Uppal. Actually, my welcome address was, before Shri Khan Garu's speech, but I am very happy. Because of a small communication gap, I am talking now. really the inspiring words and the knowledge and thoughts and information what he has shared, really it will be useful for this institution and is also a guiding map for all the teachers and the parents and the students. I thank him for his valuable speech. Now, it's my immense pleasure to have Sri Kangaroo in the midst of us. He is an all-rounder and it's not flattering, but the best chief guest school had till today. He had done his MSc chemistry and he is also a gold medalist and a role model for all the students. He is a very simple man personally and professionally a very sound man. He was commended by the government for high quality performance on several occasions and he is also a recipient of the Indian Police Medal in the year 1998 and recipient of the President Police Medal in the year 2007 for his distinguished services. And second point, as a role model, he is an example for all of us for his physical fitness. At this age also, I had seen and witnessed personally him playing cricket for 3 to 4 hours and hitting fours and sixes continuously. That shows his physical fitness and also his care towards health. He has done such important postings and crucial postings that he had to spontaneously take few critical decisions, and that is possible only when you are physically fit. Physical fitness also helps to act in a balanced manner. Thirdly, Kangaroo is a role model and example for his balanced approach, which is possible by reading books. He has mastered the Upanishads and also wrote a book on the same. Reading makes a man perfect and keeps him updated and gives him opportunity to utilize those proven situations which authors have written out of their experience. I always tell to any parent who meets me, our school focuses on all-round development, that is mentally, physically and spiritually. And I am very happy that today we have a role model here who is having all these three qualities. Myself and students recently had an opportunity to meet Dr. Kalam, former President of India. In his interaction, he asked a question to all of us. How did you come? We all excitedly told we came in vehicles. Then he asked, in how many vehicles you came? We told in 3 vehicles. He told, oh, 3 vehicles. We are producing 1 billion metric tons of pollution and we all shall be responsible towards that. That's what he told. And he told, try to use public transport or sharing transport as and when possible. Parents love their children very much and few send them to school in buses, few in sharing autos, few bring them in own vehicles. We all love our children, but we should also leave a clean environment for them to live happily and healthily. Protecting environment is not only for us, but also for the ones whom we love. So use public transport and save energy was what the Dr. Kalam's message to all of us. We at GIS provide the required environment like professionally experienced teachers who not only teach, but teach with values, which is very essential in today's world. We give thrust equally on sports like cricket, swimming, football, basketball, yoga, aerobics, etc. And we focus on child's hobbies like art and craft, painting, vocal music, instrumental, etc. All these contribute for overall personality development of a child. Let us give the children their childhood and do not give them everything in the early stages itself. Let them grow as a complete human being and let us give them all the opportunities and required platform for their success. parent is a teacher at home and teacher is a mother at school. With this, I wish all the students a very good luck and all the best for the coming performances. I thank all the parents for coming here. Do watch the entertainment program and cultural programs your children are performing. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
आए हैं हम स्वागत करने, आए हैं हम स्वागत करने, मन में आदर भाव लिए स्वागत करते हैं हम सबका, स्वागत करते हैं हम सबका, फूलों का उपहार लिए कोयल कुके गाय पपीहा, ये धरा हो रही मगन दसों दिशाएं गूंजी देखो, बागा के कहता ये मन 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 स्वागतम 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 शुभ स्वागतम। आप आए खुशियाँ लाए, ये गीत गाए, मन में उठती है तरंगे, ये पवन भी चहचहाए, गंगा सूरज लाखों तारे झूमे नाचे, ये गगन अलियां देखो मुस्काई है, कह रहा है ये चमन
बलवानयम् समनुजो choosing your battles. Pick yourself up and dust yourself off and back in the saddle. You're on the front line, everyone's watching. You know it's serious, we're getting closer, this isn't over. The pressure's off, you feel it. But you got it all, believe it. When you fold it up, oh, oh. And if you fold it up, eh, eh. Tamina, mina, sangalewa. Cause this is Africa. Tamina, mina, eh, eh. Waka, waka, eh, eh. Tamina, mina, sangalewa. This time for Africa. For Africa. Samina mina, eh eh. Waka waka, eh eh. Samina mina, sakalewa. Anawa, ah ah. Samina mina, eh eh. Waka waka, eh eh. Samina mina, sakalewa. It's time for Africa.
I'm well on my journey, biggie biggie mama. 1 A to Z. My sister's well on my journey, biggie biggie mama. From east to west, my team. Waka waka my eh eh. Waka waka my eh eh.
सब तैयार हो जाइए, आज अबारा है भालू डांस, तो जोजा जालिया से स्वागत कीजिए अपने छोटे बच्चों को.
Oh, I'm a gummy bear, yes, I'm a gummy bear. Oh, I'm a yummy, tummy, funny, lucky gummy bear. I'm a jelly bear, cause I'm a gummy bear. Oh, I'm a moving, moving, jamming, singing gummy bear. Oh, yeah, gummy, 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 gummy bear. Gummy, 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 gummy bear. Biting by Dolly Party, biting by Dolly Party, biting by Dolly Party, party pop. Biting by Dolly Party, biting by Dolly Party, biting by Dolly Party, party pop. Oh, I'm a gummy bear, yes, I'm a gummy bear. Oh, I'm a yummy, tummy, funny, lucky gummy bear. I'm a jelly bear, cause I'm a gummy bear. Oh, I'm a moving, grooving, jamming, singing gummy bear.
Three times.
gummy, 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 gummy bear.
Applaud for the boogie dance by the little one of grade 1.
मित्रों के लिए
mujha mama ani aun santa tuka unna mujha mama ani aun santa tuka ani mazori cha pila lagi tel madina cha ani mazori cha pila lagi tel madina cha undire mama I love ani pachi ponali pulo undire mama I love ani pachi ponali pulo ani mazori cha pila na taka yakana sa I love ani mazori cha pila na taka yakana sa I love ya ya ma ya 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 teu yager mezcala redondo ta jerek chiduna tata chiduna tata bagane korana pendo ta jerek chiduna tata bagane korana pendo ta kayok patlo cita pura kandalu tondu ta kayok patlo cita pura kandalu tondu are pakle choi na kare chiduna bailu rando are pakle choi na kare chiduna bailu rando ya ya ma ya 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 bule
hey ay 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 ay
degree and his friends praising him. Mr. Kalam is the topper of our college.
I'm the coach of the Indian national women's team. The states ke naam na sunai dete, na dikhai dete. Sirf ek mulk ka naam sunai deta, India.
Kuch kariye, kuch kariye, nas nas meri khode, hai kuch kariye. करिए कुछ करिए बस बस बड़ा बोले अब कुछ करिए ओ कोई तो चल सिद्ध फड़िए तू बेतरिए या मरिए हाय कोई तो चल सिद्ध फड़िए तू बेतरिए या मरिए चकले गलियों में राशन की फलियों में बैलों में बीजों में ईदों में दीजों में रेतों के दानों में फिल्मों के गानों में सड़कों के गड्ढों में बातों के अड्डों में भूखा रोज भर ले दस बारह बार कर ले
रहन यार पीछे कितना भी कोई खींचे तस है ना मस है जी जिद है तो जिद है जी किसना यूं ही किसना यूं ही किसना यूं ही पत्थर है कोई तो चल जिद फड़िए तू बेतरिए या मरिए हाय कोई तो चल जिद फड़िए तू बेतरिए या मरिए चक दे
मनों का सब जो से Thank you. मिटाने से नहीं मिटते, डराने से नहीं डरते, वतन के नाम पे
Nadri, nadri, nadri. what is the topic we are going to deal on with?
Life of Buddha and teaching of his eightfold path. Sir, can you please tell us who is Buddha?
Very good question, Shyam. Sit down. I shall explain you about Gautama Buddha and his life story. When he was a young man, he had all the luxuries and never faced any obstacles. He had to be in the palace all the time, enjoying his life. And Chinna, friend of Buddha, stand in the gallery of the palace.
really fed up with my lifestyle, and why do I need to be in this palace always? I would like to see those mountains, trees and birds which are flying with a lot of freedom. I also want to have the fragrance of flowers. I want to be friends with nature.
But a king, that's a father, will not allow us to do so.
Whatever may be the consequences, I am sure to go out. Are you accompanying me, or do you want me to go all alone?
Chenna tries to say something, but Siddharth did not want to listen anything. Siddhartha and Chenna, accompanied by four soldiers, go out of the palace. Siddhartha wonders, looking at the sceneries. Siddhartha sees an old man passing by them. An ill-health man coughing with bandage tied to his legs and arms. With other thinkers, he finally decided to find his own path and meditated for days under a peepal tree at Bodh Gaya in Bihar. Some of the Rakshasas were observing him, and they did not want him to be treated as God. They tried to disturb him, making chaos and roaming all around him. The disciples, sitting around him, were scared and ran away. Devadas finally gave up and bowed before him. They also became Lord Buddha's disciples. The disciples who left Siddhartha came back and apologized for running away without saving Lord Buddha.
From India and spread it all over the world.
Thank you. all good things come to an end, even we have come to an end of this wonderful evening. And making this event great involved the hardship of our parents, teachers, choreographers, and the students. To propose a word of thanks, I now call upon our headmistress, Miss Vidya Ma'am.
One and all, I'm sure everyone present here has enjoyed the program. It was indeed an exhilarating performance by all the students.
Honorable Chief Guest, Mr. A.K. Khan, Revered Executive Vice Chairman, Mr. Markanti Narasimha Murthy, our Director, Mrs. Saraswati, our Principal Sir, invited dignitaries, learned teachers, and dear audience. Good evening to one and all. I, Mrs. Vidya, the headmistress of this institution, deem it a great honor and privilege to propose the word of thanks to each and everyone who have contributed for the overwhelming success of today's program. First of all, I would like to convey my sincere thanks to the Honorable Chief Guest. No program of the school can be wholesome or complete without having the presence and the inspiring words of the Chief Guest. We thank you. We thank Sir for having accepted our invitation in spite of his busy schedule and having graced the occasion. I'm also very thankful to our Chairman and Director, Mr. and Mrs. Narasimha Murthy, for their remarkable presence and constant motivation to deliver the best. You've indeed been the driving force for the success of this program. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. I thank our principal, Mr. Ratanurath, for his expert and able guidance. It is needless to say that today's program would not have been such a grand success without his continuous supervision and monitoring. His meticulous planning and selfless effort enabled us to make it indeed a unique one. My grateful thanks are directed to all the distinguished guests representing various prestigious institutions who've added glamour to our program with their presence. I also extend my sincere thanks to all their parents for their excellent cooperation. We shall remember your contribution in allowing and encouraging your wards to participate in this program and making it a success. Any program cannot achieve success without imparting sufficient training to the students. The wonderful songs and colorful items of our show reveal as to how much our beloved teachers have put in their tireless efforts in imparting perfect training to the students. I extend my special thanks to Mr. Vamshi and his crew for training our institute for students with a lot of patience. My thanks also goes to the members of the media who have always cooperated to attend our programs to give a wider coverage. The appropriate lighting, sound and music system provided by the company has richly enhanced the grandeur of the show, and I thank them sincerely. I shall be failing in my duty if I don't express my gratitude to the supporting staff who have contributed their share to the success of today's program. I once again thank everyone for their cooperation in making today's show a grand success. Thank you to one and all. To end, on behalf of the management, I would like to thank all the parents for gracing the occasion and making it a success. And also, may the Makar Sankranti fire burn away all the moments of sadness and bring all warmth of joy, happiness, love and peace to you and your family. On behalf of the management, I wish one and all a very happy Sankranti. Thank you.
And I am one of the recent Nobel Peace Prize winners this year. I, along with Ms. Malala Yousafzai, the youngest Nobel Peace Prize winner in history, thank you for coming here. And I was rewarded this Nobel Peace Prize for my work towards the community of the children, the children's rights, the most important. The future of India is our children. But a lot of children nowadays are employed to work for other people in shops or whatever business may it be. I've seen a lot of things that like that that happen, but I don't want that to happen, because everyone, even Malala Yousafzai, even said, everyone deserves education, no matter what gender, religion, age, no matter what. But why do people make these children labor hard, harder and stronger and more hours than other people? I have always rightly said, I will see the end of child labor through my lifetime. So I hope we all can help the children, the future of India, to grow not only in strength but in intelligence. Happy Shankranti and good evening.